Hey guys, I'm here at Fairway, which is where I actually do a lot of my shopping. When it comes to beef, chicken, and eggs, there are so many labels. It's easy to get overwhelmed. You might think that organic is the way to go when it comes to protein, but that's not necessarily the case. When it comes to eggs, the two things that I'm looking out for are omega-3s and pasture-raised, which means that the chicken was allowed to roam around and eat its natural diet, which might gross you out, but chickens like to eat bugs. All right, so when it comes to chicken, you don't have to buy organic, but what I'm looking for is grown with no antibiotics and no hormones and free range. A free range chicken is basically allowed to get more exercise and therefore it's less fatty. And then hormones and antibiotics, I mean, who wants that in your system? When you're buying beef, you don't necessarily need it to be organic, but definitely make sure that it's 100% grass-fed. It makes the fat significantly healthier. It has less saturated fat, and it has more vitamin E and significantly more carotenoids, which are compounds that actually protect your eyes and brain. Everybody asks me how to eat healthier on a budget, so these are my top ways of saving while still eating brain-healthy foods. So when it comes to produce, there's no need to buy organic if you're not eating the skin. I rarely buy organic avocados and seldom buy organic bananas. When it comes to eating for optimal brain health, there are foods that you can combine for maximum impact. All right, so when it comes to meat, you want to use garlic in your preparation because garlic can help prevent certain potentially carcinogenic compounds from forming when you cook the beef. When eating starchier foods like rice or potatoes, try adding some apple cider vinegar, which inhibits enzymes in the small intestine that break down the starch. This will leave you with a less dramatic blood sugar swing, which might make you feel less lethargic afterwards. So adding turmeric to your diet is a great idea, but you want to also add black pepper, which can increase the bioactivity of curcumin, an anti-inflammatory component of turmeric, by up to 2,000%. Well, I got everything I need. Hopefully you're ready for your next trip to the supermarket.
So now what are we gonna start with today, Max? We're gonna start with a couple of tips that are
non-food related.
Non-food related.
Yeah, okay. So one of the things that I think is really important is to start taking colder showers.
Well, why?
It boosts mental acuity. I mean, it's one of the few things that you can actually do and feel a marked difference in how you feel before and after. And it actually gives a small region of your brain called the locus coeruleus a workout. And that region of the brain is associated with early Alzheimer's progression. And then on that same tip, you know, thermal stress, I also want to talk about saunas. Saunas are something that they practice all the time in Finland.
Totally.
Are you a fan of saunas?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, so I mean, saunas, Finland is the sauna capital of the world, and really robust research out of Finland has shown that people who use saunas 4 to 7 times per week were able to achieve a remarkable 65% risk reduction for Alzheimer's disease.
Wow.
That's incredible.
That's incredible.
Why?
Yeah. Well,
does the research even guess at that?
Like, yeah.
Why?
Well, it does. So it seems to reduce blood pressure and inflammation and improve something called vascular compliance. So, your brain is fed blood and nutrients by a network of microvessels. I mean, blood flow is very important to your brain. And so it seems to really boost vascular health. And it also activates something called heat shock proteins, which actually, very interestingly, act like scaffolding for other proteins in your body to prevent misfolding. Alzheimer's disease is characterized by protein misfolding.
That's really interesting. You know, they always say that the happiest people in the world are Scandinavian from
those
countries.
Yeah.
And I just wonder,
that's
maybe
why
it's
I love
just
Denmark
interesting
so
to know.
Yeah,
maybe the saunas are a big reason for it.